Hey folks, so I'm trying to bring you videos about once a week about some of the things that I do to stay young. And you know, once I decided to go silver, everyone always asked me, oh my gosh, your hair, how'd you make that decision? How'd you do it? Oh my gosh, was it awful? Was it awful? And sure, it was a tough decision to make, but it was much worse to dye my hair for 25 years. Oh my gosh, I went gray at 25. So I've been dyeing my hair for 25 years. So for me, it was a relief. And once I decided that I was going to do it, and believe me, I belabored it, then it was like, okay, now I got to get the rest of my life in shape because I don't want people thinking that, you know, I have a young energy and I do a lot of stuff and I go hiking and I, you know, in fact, maybe I already told you guys this, but I just did 51 miles, 52 miles in 5 days with a 28-pound pack going to 13,200 feet. So, you know, and bad night's sleep every night in a tent. So, you know, like I still want to do stuff and I don't want people writing me off because of my hair because that would make me mad. Yeah. So I do all these other things to beyond the gray hair, keep the rest of it all working. So I'm just coming to you slowly once a week with the tips that I do that work for me, stuff that works for me. So hopefully it works for you, and I wanted to pass it along. So I'm passing along today's tip, and it comes from Dr. Greger. Oh, how I love him. Okay, so my nutrition nerd, I was interviewing him on my podcast, Awesome Vegans, and I said, oh yeah, you know, I do this great breakfast. I'll link to it in this interview. I do this great breakfast. It's raw tofu and hemp seeds and fresh fruit and raw oats and maple syrup. And he was like, nuh-uh, you got to do date syrup because it's a lot less processed. It's lower glycemic index, so it processes through your body slower to sugar, so you don't get that spike and high in your blood sugar. And it comes from dates. Right from dates. And so now if I had the time, I would take dates, I would add water, I would take dates, I would puree them, and then I would add water and I would simmer that and I would make my own date syrup at home. I'm not doing that, but I do use Date Lady. You can see this. I use this every day. Every day I put a tablespoon of date syrup in my raw tofu, oats, hemp seed, fresh fruit. And it's what I live on every day for breakfast. And it's so good. And I just wanted to pass it along to you because since Dr. Greger turned me on to some date syrup, I use it in cooking and I bake a lot. And I've got a lot of cooking demos that you guys can see, cooking recipes. And now I really substitute out for date syrup. So it's just a better alternative. Of course, the best is to get rid of sugar, period, you know? So if you could, that would be fantastic. And of course, you keep all your processed foods to a minimum. And I'm not gonna lie, you know, this isn't a whole date. It comes from whole dates, but you know, so it is processed to a certain degree, and but you're just trying to minimize that. And so this is better than sugar or better than even maple syrup, which I sort of always thought was good for me. So I just wanted to pass that tip along that if you too love to bake or if you too love sweets, because I mean, who does not love sweets? Then try date syrup. Certainly works for me every morning. It's what I have to get me going and I don't feel any kind of sugar spikes, but consider switching out your really processed white sugar for other versions of sugar if you're going to use it at all in your diet. I hope that tip is helpful for you. Be sure to hit the subscribe button. It's around there somewhere. YouTube's just changed things. I'm sure I'm gonna find where to put the new button, but be sure to hit the subscribe button, or of course, always go to my website, elizabethalfano.com. Lots of recipes there and even more videos just like this. Thanks everybody. See you later. Bye.